The Honourable Leader of the New Democratic Party.
Well, the email account of which my colleague speaks was under the oversight and care of the then Minister of Health's executive assistant. And when the Information and Privacy Commissioner requested to be able to interview that person, the response she received came from a deputy minister in the Premier's office to say that that interview was not going to take place. So the Premier has been asked by my colleague for an explanation, but I don't believe we've heard it for this interference in this investigation.
The Honourable Premier.
Mr. Speaker, it was not the Premier's office as you are describing it from the political side, Mr. Speaker. The clerk is also the head of public service. The request was going in to ask for the officer wanted to interview someone she does not have the authority to interview. The clerk, upon looking at that, realized that the very thing she wanted to interview him on had already been dealt with. We actually agreed with the FOIPOP officer that the minister should not be using his personal account. We fixed that problem. The minister acknowledged that. That is what the process was going through, Mr. Speaker. That's why the decision was made by the clerk.
The Honourable Leader of the New Democratic Party.
The Information Commissioner has cautioned that it's possible for personal emails to be wrongly used to provide shield for material from legitimate Freedom of Information requests. Now, the government, she says, failed in this case to make any effort to comply with a legitimate Freedom of Information request for personal emails that had been used in the minister's public capacity. And this, she says in her report, was offside and was out of line. Now, the Premier is responsible for the tone, the standard of transparency and forthrightness of the entire administration. So I want to ask, does this behaviour meet the standard that he sets?
Honourable Premier.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Again, I want to thank the Honourable Member for the question. Mr. Speaker, what happened was there was a FOIPOP request coming in by an agency, Mr. Speaker. They were looking for an entire year window. What went back to them? Can you narrow the scope? They narrowed the scope to 3 months. All of the information and all of the requests that they were looking for was turned over to that applicant, Mr. Speaker. I don't know the number of pages there were, but they were turned over to the applicant who asked for the information, Mr. Speaker. That's how that process works. There was nothing hidden from the person who actually asked for the information. We turned it over to them.
The Honourable Leader of the New Democratic Party.
Commissioner Tully has made a number of recommendations flowing out of this investigation, but none of these is binding because her office doesn't have the power to enforce them. And prior to the election, the Premier had said that if elected, this is a quotation, he would expand the powers and mandate of the Office of the Information and Privacy Commissioner, particularly through granting her order-making powers. And earlier this week, the Premier said this was no longer the view that he takes and that that previous view had been mistaken. But does the Premier understand that his change of heart on this front gives every indication of a person who is being opportunistic about their integrity and selective about honouring their word?
The Honourable Premier.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I appreciate the Honourable Member for the question. Mr. Speaker, I'm very proud of my track record of dealing with Nova Scotians, communicating directly even when there's difficult information that's required to be handed out, Mr. Speaker. I go and do that on behalf of our government, Mr. Speaker. That is the role that I've accepted. That's the role I ask for, and I'll continue to do so. Mr. Speaker, I do want to say to the Honourable Member, we go through the information, we require the information, we put it out. What the information officer, Mr. Speaker, is looking for, we reply to almost all the recommendations she puts forward. We will look at those ones, Mr. Speaker, we go through. We'll continue to make sure that we do that. But I want to go back, Mr. Speaker, to the very the beginning of this particular situation was, the information officer said to the former Minister of Health, and now current Minister of Communities, Culture and Heritage, you shouldn't be doing government work on your Gmail account. He agreed. We accepted it. He moved on.